This may look unusual to see many animals that are found in separate places of the world living together, but this is normal in the pre-flood world. This dinosaur is called Iguanodon. It was named after the iguana lizard. Iguanodon has been one of the most successful dinosaurs to thrive on Earth because their fossils were found on three continents. In fact, 30 Iguanodon skeletons were found deep underground in a coal mine in Belgium. Iguanodon was also the first plant-eating dinosaur found, and the second kind of dinosaur to be discovered in the world. At first, when Iguanodon was discovered, people made statues of it looking like giant rhinoceros iguanas. People thought that Iguanodon had a horn on its nose. However, it turns out to be a sharp thumb spike. When the Iguanodon walks, his hands would stand on three fingers, while the one finger and thumb spike remain above ground. He can also stand on two legs when running, or for other purposes. Iguanodon could probably eat around 300 pounds of plants per day. That's half as much as what an average elephant would eat. God made the thumb spike to grow 4 to 6 inches long, and it might have been used as a tool to grab plant food. But later, it would be used as a weapon for fighting. Now, Iguanodon is a kind of ornithopod dinosaur. The hadrosaurids are ornithopods too. However, some ornithopod species were not designed with a duck-like bill. The Iguanodon, for example, was designed with a reptilian-like beak. In this chapter, we'll be talking about all different kinds of ornithopod dinosaurs that God made. Altarhinus is another species of Iguanodon, but some people think that it's a species of the hadrosaurids. Like the Iguanodon, Altarhinus can walk on four legs and can stand and run on two legs. The nose is what makes the Altarhinus unique. It's called a nasal arch. God probably made it for storage, or gave it an extra good sense of smell, or for communication, or even for display. Some people would guess that only the males would have it to attract a mate. Much like how God made the male elephant seals' nose long and the females short. Altarhinus were designed with a thumb spike too, and they would use them for weapons and tools to open up fruits. God made their beaked mouths wide to help them grab more plant food in one bite, and they can use their cheek teeth to chew their plant food down and swallow it. When you are pretending to eat like a dinosaur, try to be like ones who uses good table manners, like how the Altarhinus chews the food in his cheeks. We don't know how God made each of his dinosaur creations to socialize, whether if they are being led by a king, or a queen, or both, or even if they live alone or in groups. Of course, many fossils and footprints can give us clues, but the answer will still not be as clear as we would see elephants in herds, fishes in schools, birds in flocks, whales in pods, or even lions in prides. Camptosaurus, meaning bent lizard, is probably called that because of how God designed its whole body. You see, Camptosaurus was once thought to have spent its entire life walking on two legs. However, God strengthened their arms to support their weight and made their backs in an arched shape. This makes them able to walk and eat plants on all four legs. Camptosaurus also has a thumb claw like the Iguanodon, but unlike the Iguanodon, God made the three middle fingers separated like our hands and not all together in one like the Iguanodon's. Their remains were found in the USA, and they were also known to be near larger dinosaurs like Stegosaurus and Diplodocus for protection. The Camptosaurus doesn't have any means of defense, and so they have to keep an eye out for predators. If they see one, they'll use their gifted speedy legs to try and outrun the predator. The predator is a Megalosaurus, the first dinosaur that was ever discovered in the world. The predator runs at a speed of almost 30 miles per hour. Its bones were first discovered more than 340 years ago in 1676. Its large bones were thought to have come from giant people like Goliath. However, 148 years later, in 1824, more bones of it were found, and William Buckland called it the Megalosaurus. Since then, more large bones were found, and it was because of the discovery of the Megalosaurus that began the age of paleontology, and later Sir Richard Owen invented the animal word dinosaur. Megalosaurus was once mistakenly thought to have looked like a big, bulking lizard as shown at Crystal Palace Park in London. But later, more research and observation over the years say that the caricature was wrong. Using his sense of smell, the Megalosaurus picks up the scent of a Camptosaurus that had already died of old age. Right now, vultures and a grizzly bear are already feasting on the carcass. The Megalosaurus may look like a T-Rex, but he's much smaller than it. He would be like a wolf next to a lion. Plus, the Megalosaurus has strong arms and three fingers. Scientists had found lots of footprints or trace fossils of the Megalosaurus, but they didn't find too much of its bones even to this day. Muttaburrasaurus, meaning Muttaburra lizard, was named after a town called Muttaburra in Queensland, Australia. God designed a deep bony bump on the Muttaburrasaurus' nose, which might have been used for communication. Some people think that the Muttaburrasaurus has tissues on its snout and would puff up like a balloon whenever they make any calls. God had designed similar features to other animals such as frogs and hooded seals. They can create balloon-like shapes whether for sounds or display. God designed the Muttaburrasaurus' mouth with a front beak and rigid teeth that were probably as sharp as garden shears. The teeth were probably designed more for slicing rather than grinding plant food, and some people think that the Muttaburrasaurus also ate meat because of the sharpness of the teeth. But that might be unlikely, and the Muttaburrasaurus might be 100% herbivore. In the documentary called Walking with Dinosaurs, the Muttaburrasaurus was shown walking on two legs. However, others think that it walked on all four legs, but could stand on two legs when reaching for food high up or running. Late at night, a Tenontosaurus feeds on ferns. The first Tenontosaurus was discovered in the year 1903 in the state of Montana. The famous Barnum Brown called it Tenontosaurus because God had designed a network of strong tendons in its back, hips, and tail. However, 67 years later, John Ostrom replaced the first A for an O, and to this day, this is called a Tenontosaurus. God made its tail more than half as long as the entire body. Some people think that it was designed to help balance the Tenontosaurus while it stands up to reach the plant food that are high up. What's famous about the Tenontosaurus is that its fossils were found next to the fossils of Deinonychus, a predatory raptor dinosaur. A popular one was discovered where an adult Tenontosaurus skeleton was surrounded by five adult Deinonychus skeletons. Most people believe that the Tenontosaurus killed these five before the remaining ones, the survivors of the pack, could kill it. However, another suggestion is that the Tenontosaurus and the five Deinonychus were drowned by the Great Flood while they were fighting. It seems that the Tenontosaurus will be having trouble sleeping because of the annoying but fascinating loon birds. The common loons are still existing to this day, and they are not actually ducks because God made a loon's skeleton heavy, so you won't see too much of their body floating like a duck. God designed four different kinds of calls for a common loon. The long wolf-like howl sound means that he's letting others far away know where he is. Those other sounds that the two males are making means that they are either feeling threatened or being territorial. Oranosaurus is probably the only known species of ornithopod that God designed with a sail on its back. Some people think that it was designed as a temperature regulator, like how the Armargosaurus, Edaphosaurus, and Dimetrodon would use their sails. Some people think that the sails would be used for display. Other people had also suggested that it might have been used to store food. Like a camel's hump, the fat from the food that the Tyrannosaurus ate would be stored in the sail. God designed other features for the Tyrannosaurus, such as having a beaked mouth to pull plant food and chew them with their cheek teeth. Also, God designed their hands to look almost like iguanodon hands, including thumb spikes. It's amazing how God made such a dinosaur that you don't usually see with other ornithopods. And God didn't make anything from something else except from his own hands. He made everything by his hands.